So how do I know what a real Aussie is?
What's a real Aussie anyway?
Well, he doesn't look like me, that's for sure.
Well, he doesn't look like me either. How many women are they looking at?
None.
Well, there goes half the population for a start.
Apparently he had changed his name to his uncle's. That's why we had trouble finding him.
My son is well? He is all right?
Well, he's certainly been working very hard. He's managed to save enough for your fares.
Then we can go? We can be in Australia?
Mum, Ba's not finished.
That's right, I'm not finished. Unfortunately, Hian is not 18 years old yet. He's not old enough to sponsor you.
You mean we can't go to Australia?
I promise you we'll try and find you a sponsor as soon as we can. It may take a little time. You'll have to be patient a while longer.
Ta mới làm trong già mà giờ mà quên rồi hả? Không có khe sao?
Được rồi mời. Cái xe đi không biết được, không giết anh em tụi tao đó.
Đúng rồi. Thiệt không? Hả? Này, thiệt không? Bỏ tao đi.
Chừng shit.
Ê, anh đi luôn. Dẹp mày đi.
They began to pull it down. Berlin saw the most extraordinary
reigns briefly. In Tiananmen Square, a lone protester takes a stand against the might of the communist giant.
Sudan has been defeated in the mother of all battles, but at a terrible cost.
It's triumph for the new world order. Peace and disarmament at the stroke of a pen. George Bush.
They struck at the Viet Cong from the air, huge shattering blows to the countryside which would scar Vietnam. And those
onto the streets. Tens of thousands of students were saying no to the war and no to the draft.
As the Viet Cong closed in, a terrifying scramble for safety. Only those South Vietnamese with the best connections or
the ambitious and businesslike Vietnamese have carved their own niche in our cities. Their food and their festivals are familiar part.
How long you noticed him?
A few days now. Doesn't come out much.
He's been staying up the top there.
Yeah, a couple of weeks now.
Okay, thanks for that. I'll be in touch.
As a matter of fact, I am in the army. Give him a warning, wrap him up a bit, and throw him back on the streets. He'll live.
Yeah, why are we getting anywhere with this?
Hmm? You told me you'd be able to use Tran as an informant because he's in trouble with the triad, right? Well, next time you see him, you just push him hard.
Well, I'll need another week.
Hey, you got 24 hours. I want names of his buyers and suppliers. I want an in into this whole bloody heroin network
like
business.
Like I said, that'll take at least
a results,
week.
Get results, Angie. Do your job, all right?
Whatever you say, boss. Something came to me last night. When Tran did that deal in Smith Street?
With his mate Lee.
That's right. I remembered how easily Lee got away from those thugs. Right, how quickly he reacted. Almost too quickly, you know, like he was expecting them or something.
Oh, you reckon Lee set up his mate?
He's a junkie. He's desperate.
All right. Let's play this very carefully. Angie, get Wyatt.
Bloody cops had me in there for 3 hours, Lee.
What were they talking to you for?
They reckon Tran was murdered.
That's crazy. He shot himself.
I know. That's what I kept telling them. They wouldn't listen to me. They've got it into their heads that somebody killed him and they made it look like a suicide.
Oh, that's so stupid. Why would anyone do that?
I don't know. Hey, I've got something for you.
Is that Tran's watch?
Yeah. Cops gave me some of his stuff. Didn't feel right for me to keep it. You're his friend. I thought you might like it.
Thanks, Jenny. Tran was one of the best.
Who'd want to kill him?
Oh, look, it could have been anybody. It could have been the triad, could have been the other dealers, could have been customers he ripped off, and maybe it was the police. He wouldn't put anything past the police. You know?
You know, in a way, I hope somebody did kill him. I don't like thinking he did that to himself. Hey, I'll be seeing you.
Yeah.
She told me the police suspect that Tran was murdered. Look, if they think it's murder, they'll be investigating. It'll be a murder investigation.
You seem nervous.
I am nervous.
should breathe slowly.
This doesn't seem to worry you at all. If they start poking around, it could be very bad for us.
I don't see how.
Look, if I'm caught, they may have discovered that you forced me to kill Tran.
Keep talking, keep talking.
How would they know that?
I didn't mean I would talk.
Lee, calm down. Everything is fine. I promise you something. If you ever get arrested, I'll make sure that you are dead before you get a chance to say anything to incriminate me.
I wouldn't. I'm not going to say anything. Look, when you asked me to kill Tran, I did so without question.
You can trust me. I've proven that.
We've got what we need, Bill. Move in on your command.
You may go.
Lee Van Tew, Jim Quartet.
Look out, he's got a weapon!
Hands on the table! Put it down!
You!
Everyone stay calm. Please remain where you are. The situation is under control.
Clear, Judge.
We have a man down. We'll secure it.
No need to thank me.
This is the first play of its type ever written by an Australian with a Vietnamese background in Australia about the Vietnamese people here.
Okay, is it a, what sort of a play is it? Is it one of hope? Is it one of with a lot of problems involved? What sort of tack do you take?
When I set out to write this play, it was more for the Vietnamese people. It's for them to look at themselves, more than writing a play about, you know, Vietnamese for non-Vietnamese people. You know, it's for, that's why it's more important. It's a play for Vietnamese people, but at the same time, I'm giving the non-Vietnamese people a chance to see what's the world like within the Vietnamese community.
In Australia.
In Australia.